So today we changed tactics a little bit. Where the last time I worked with Stella, we were just getting her used to, or getting her rewarded for sitting on the towel, going to the towel, looking at the towel, stepping on the towel, whatever she did near the towel. Today I started throwing the treats off to the side and letting her come back towards the towel on her own by me standing on the other side of it, and off to the side of it or some other place, just a little bit now and then, so that I could try to get her to figure out that it's not coming over towards me and sitting, or coming over towards me and laying down that she's getting rewarded for. It's actually going towards the towel that she's getting the rewards for. And she does start to pick up on this quite a bit better. She also starts to do a lot more of the automatic down or lay down on her own, where a couple times I prompted her with my body language. It wasn't quite luring. I didn't always bring my hand down to the floor, but I just kind of leaned over a little bit, gave her a little prompt, so that she would think, hey, I bet she might be giving me the cue to lay down. And so then she would start to lay down. This was increasing the criteria, where in these first few sets, she got rewarded just for coming over to the towel, touching the towel, sitting on the towel. And pretty soon I wouldn't reward her until she laid down on the towel. And she was really, really focused on me today. There were some other people coming in and out of the shop as we were doing this, and she knew right where the rewards were. We were able to do this off leash and without any other training tools. This is a thinking dog. This is why it's great to teach your dog to think and to help them please you, or to help them want to please you. This is so much better than training your dog with forceful methods. Although Stella isn't my dog, the bond that I've built with her while we do this training will transfer over to the incredible bond that she has with her owner. And she absolutely loves people. She loves just about every person, every dog that she meets, as far as I know, from what I've seen. And so this is going to take her a long ways in life. She's a really young dog, but she's going to do well. And when I say really young dog, any dog under 2 or 3 years old is so much easier to train than a dog that's 5 or 7 years old. But I will take my 6-year-old dog out in the next couple of weeks and do some of the same stuff with him and show you. See, here you see me prompting her. I'm just kind of kneeling over, leaning forward a little bit. I'm not really saying anything to her. I'm just looking at her. And there she goes, down. Yes, good girl. Give her those rewards. Reward her off the bed, tossing the treat, and then that gets her the opportunity to come back to it and look for more rewards. I lean over a little bit more. Again, this time she looks off at a little bit of distraction. My husband's there working in the shop. But boom, she goes down again. That's great. Yes, Stella. Remember, our yes word is the positive marker. Yes is the same as a click. If we were doing clicker training, click marks the spot, and yes marks the spot. The very second she did that right, and she really keys in on that word. She loves to hear the word yes, because she knows that at that very second, she got it right.
Yes, good girl. Yes.